chairs. That tells me we have so many more parents coming out tonight and supporting us and supporting your children. Tonight we are recognizing almost 200 of our students for their academic achievements, more so than we've recognized in several years for the things that they've been doing here at the high school. So let's go ahead and give them a round of applause. For this. Again, all of this would not be possible without the educators we have in this room. And to my right, or to my left, behind me in the corner there, we had to take them out of the bleachers this year and put them on the floor, is our teaching staff. So if our teaching staff would please stand at this time to be recognized. Thank you. Thank you. We also have with us our superintendent, Mr. Arena, over on the side. Board members here are in the capacity of board members and board members in the capacity of parents. So if you're a board member, please stand to be recognized. Without further ado, we're going to get started. We have several awards to give out tonight. We want to keep this as quick as possible so you can enjoy the after party, wherever that may be, and some refreshments in just a few minutes. So thank you all for coming. I appreciate your support to give us and to your child and the support for our school.
In the homes, the neighborhoods, the students, and government as it relates to our community. motto is, we can't afford to wait. This year, we have been so fortunate. We have been so fortunate. Instead of two scholarships, we are giving three. We are giving three. Now, I must tell you that this scholarship is named for a lady I have wished to goodness I could have met. It's the Vernice Joy Knuckles Scholarship Award. This lady, a son donates to us, and we save him the money and give it back to our young people, our future leaders. That's what we do. And this is what your letter is going to say, young people. It says, congratulations. You are one of the few chosen seniors of Putnam County High School to receive the annual Vernice Joy Knuckles Award Scholarship. This scholarship is only given to those that have proven their skills through academics and community involvement. You have adequately proven these skills. As a reward for being a responsible and successful student, a monetary contribution will be given directly to the institution with confirmation your acceptance from your chosen college has been received. Once again, congratulations on a job well done. Young people, get it to us as soon as you can. A copy of your letter of acceptance to your student and a check will go out. We are able to give each one of these recipients a $500 scholarship. My first one is Samantha Ruga. I wish to goodness we could. But you know something, with our little club, they will not let me be on the committee for selecting scholarship recipients. They say, I know everybody, so I'm not going to. Last but definitely not least, our third scholarship goes to Miss Dakota Young.
Children, kids in preschool, and even we do have a program that we read every week to them. And our biggest fundraiser is Pancake Supper every first year. In January and February, we have Pancake Supper. And May 21st, next Thursday, on the courthouse lawn at 7 o'clock, we will honor our veterans. I see a few Marines here tonight. And right now, I'd like to introduce George Barrett. He's our chairperson for our scholarship program. And Mr. George, will you come?
Good evening. It's always a pleasure to come here and to present these scholarships. Before I was able to graduate from college, I was just sharing a few moments with the three gentlemen to my right. This, before there was this college education, there was a little different one. It was called Starting at Paris Island and spending 4 years with our friends over here. And I want to congratulate them on their presence here tonight. I also would like to, there's been some thank yous going around, but there's two folks here that also spend an awful lot of time with these students here, and that's Ms. Kennedy and Mr. Adams, who deserve a round of applause. When I was here to get out of scholarship, I met a sibling of the recipient of that scholarship at that time, and I said to her, make sure you send us an application. Well, lo and behold, I got an application, and this year, our Kiwanis Scholarship winner is Miss Abby Wolf.
name is Alex Falanga, and I'm very honored to be here on behalf of the Rotary Club of Greene and Putnam Counties. I'm here this evening to present to one very deserving student our Rotary Student of the Year Award. And our Student of the Year Award is a culmination of our Student and Teacher of the Month program. And that's a program where each of the four area high schools identifies a superlative student for us to recognize, and they in turn recognize a quite deserving teacher that has touched their lives. And we do this for 8 months of the school year, and out of those eight students that have been chosen, we in turn choose one student of the year to receive a scholarship and obviously the recognition of being our Rotary Student of the Year. I'm very proud and honored to announce, if you all have seen our Super Raffle, that was our local community fundraiser. And one of the things that we made a point of doing was that we were going to spend this money and give back directly to the community. And I'm also honored this evening to announce that this has always been a $500 scholarship, but due to the Super Raffle, each of these four area high schools are now a $1,000 scholarship. And this year's recipient is a very honorable and definitely deserving student. I'm very proud to give this student and recognize them as the 2015 Rotary Student of the Year for Putnam County High School is Zhang Zhong Zhu.
Scholarship Board. Since 1989, the People's Bank Foundation has awarded over $113,000 in scholarships to 93 Putnam County seniors. Tonight's representatives, who will receive scholarships in the amount of $1,000 each, are among the brightest and the most qualified recipients we have ever had. Our board was just in awe this year over these young ladies. We are so proud to be a part of their very promising futures. The recipients are Carrie Clemens, also Kiana Reed.
Good evening, my name is Charlotte Green. I'm representing the Pilot Club of Eden, which I'm president this year, and we're giving out two scholarships. For our two Putnam County students. First one is the Citizenship Award. The Pilot Club of Eden recognizes a member of the senior class who demonstrates the characteristics of a good citizen. Honesty, compassion, respect, responsibility, and courage. The recipient is chosen by the school faculty and members of the senior class. This year's certificate for $100, Rekima Griffin. The second one is the Pat Lane Scholarship. The Pat Lane Sunshine Personality Scholarship was established through the Pilot Club of Eden in honor and memory of her, by her husband, Joe Lane, in 1993. Pat was a beloved member of the Pilot Club of Eaton from 1985 until her death in 1993. This scholarship was established to perpetuate her sunny personality and love of life through a female student who possesses the characteristics that make Pat special. She was screened by school faculty and chosen by a panel of Pilot Club members. The recipient of this year's $1,000 scholarship is Kristen Dakota Young.
I'm Sue Adams, representing the Lake Country Board of Realtors, and let me just say how proud and privileged we are to be part of this wonderful program tonight. We are so proud of all these young people and their accomplishments. At this time, it's my honor to present $1,000 in scholarship on behalf of the Lake Country Board of Realtors to a student who has demonstrated outstanding community service, dedication, leadership, and academic excellence. Shelby Henson.
Following somebody else. Okay, my name is Captain Matt Malalu. I'm here from the United States Marine Corps. This is Staff Sergeant Schomburg, Staff Sergeant Galladay. We're here tonight to present the Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps Scholarship. Now, this scholarship was established and program was established in 1926 by the Navy. In 1932, the Marine Corps petitioned and created the Marine Option. This allowed this individual to enter into the Marine Corps upon graduation from a qualifying college institution. This prestigious scholarship provides for full tuition, books, fees, and a monthly stipend until graduation, and then ultimately a commission in the United States Marine Corps. The value of this scholarship is roughly around $200,000, depending on the institution, based on the uniforms and everything that comes with that training and whatnot. So the recipient here, upon graduation, commissions into the United States Marine Corps, where they will, at about the age of 23, lead America's most precious asset, its youth. From there, the Marine Corps prides itself on winning every battle it's fought for the last 239 years. And now this young man, in a very tumultuous time, is going to add a patch to the quilt that provides a blanket of freedom for all America. Through this highly competitive process, it was found that this awardee is exactly what the world's most feared fighting force is looking for, a volunteer in their community, a scholar athlete, and as I saw throughout the process, the interview process, and the application process, that this awardee meets that Marine Corps ethos. The acclaimed author Thomas Ricks once said, "The United States Marine Corps, with its fiercely proud tradition of excellence in combat, its hallowed rituals, and its unbending code of honor, is part of the fabric of the American myth." Tonight, I would like to present this NRTC scholarship and offer Deontay McBride the opportunity.
For those of you who do not know who we are, where we are, we're the steel gray building next to the silver moon. The Community Association is a group of folks who meet once a month. We have a speaker come in and we have an educational process. And we're also dedicated to trying to give back and reach into our community, regardless of where that community is. And we have no dues. We have no membership fees. We have no corporate sponsors. I shamelessly have to ask you, we do have a fish fry Memorial Day from 11 to 2, and that's what funds our scholarships. And the more of you we see that day, the more scholarships we can have. This year, the Harmony Community Association Scholarship, we had 11 applications, very fine people, and I wish we had 11 scholarships. We had to look for that person who dug the deepest and reached the hardest, and who is just a stellar example of what you can do if you commit to it. This year, our scholarship for $1,000 goes to Caitlin Rollerson.
Representing Farmers and Merchants Bank tonight. The goal of the Julian and Jan Hester Memorial Scholarship is to assist deserving high school seniors in the first year of college and to promote community banking. The scholarship is named after longtime CBA Chief Executive Officer, the late Julian Hester, and his late daughter, Jan Hester. Jan was a senior at UGA when she passed away in a car accident in April of 1990. In addition to supporting community banking, this scholarship is an opportunity to pass on the positive qualities both Julian and Jan Hester exemplified to further the development in tomorrow's generations. Farmers and Merchants Bank sponsors a local student each year to compete for this scholarship. Along with the scholarship, they will receive a $500 scholarship from this bank. The student had to compete in the activity record expressing their leadership activity in school, write an essay on community banking, provide teacher recommendations, and high school transcripts. On behalf of Farmers and Merchants Bank, I would like to congratulate Shelby Henson for being chosen as 2015 local leader.
I'm Janet Kellhofer, and I'm representing the Plaza Arts Center. For the past 3 years, we have offered scholarships. We call it the Putnam Performing Arts Partnership Scholarship, or P3 for short. And they're in instrumental music or vocal performance, theater arts, and visual arts. This year, we have two winners in the field of instrumental music, Rosie Dennis. Make sure she gets this. And then in the field of visual arts, Shelby Lawrence.
Once again, I'd like to thank all the donors of these scholarships for the outstanding work they do. It's a pleasure to work with them each and every year. Let's give them one more round of applause. Some scholarship money that we want to recognize. Just we want to have them stand. Karen Penner received some scholarship money from Mercer. And Haley Bowen for Berry College, $9,500. Now move on to the certificate presentations for individual awards for students in no particular order. Our first award is a nurse's aide certificate for Lydia Davis. Woo! next for Kira Daniels, highest average in world history. Award, Ashley Crooks, a nurse's aide certificate. Our next is Dawson Crisco for criminal justice specialist and fundamental certificate. Next is DeMarcus Crawford for the opening number for Georgia Thespians. Our next award, Jared Coronado for the Kennesaw State Mathematic Competition highest scoring student and a nurse's certificate. Cordova, AC Technician Assistant and Universal EPA Certificate. Carson Corbett for Outstanding Accomplishment Dedication in Theater. Dennis Connor, criminal justice specialist and fundamental certificate. Ashley Collis for the audiovisual tech and film pathway assessment. Trinicia Clemens, Nurses Aid Certificate. Taylor Clemens, Highest Grade Analytic Geometry. Carrie Clemens, Georgia Best Certificate. Clayton Clemens for Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment and Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder Certificates. Madison Clark for CPR and First Aid Certificates. Terrence Childs, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. David Chapman, Georgia Best Certificate. Casey, highest average in honors American Lit Com. Grady Carnes, CPR and first aid certificates, and gas and basic shield and arc metal welder certificates. Autumn Calhoun, outstanding dedication to musical theater. Priscilla Brown, Georgia Best Certificate. Mankisa Brown, Nurse's Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Vertical Advanced Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificates, and AC Technician Assistant and Universal Certificate. Each year, University of Georgia recognizes the top juniors and with a certificate, recognizing their academic standing. And our first certificate from the University of Georgia goes to Garrett Brown. Stephen Bowers, Georgia Best Certificate. Jesse Bowers, the Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment and the highest grade in Advanced Algebra. Haley Bowen, highest grade in Pre-Calculus and the Georgia Best Certificate. Mathematical Decision Making, a Georgia Best Certificate, a CPR Certificate, and a First Aid Certificate. Tyler Black, a Nurse's Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Winner Barlow, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Wesley Ayers, Vertical Advanced Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Crystal Areola, highest grade in Spanish 4, Georgia Certificate of Merit, the highest average in U.S. history, and a Nurse's Aid Certificate. Juan Fernando Alvarez Tapia, Vertical Advanced Shielding Metal Arc Welder Certificate and Georgia Best Certificate. Technician Assistant and Universal EPA Certificate. Tyler DeLoach, Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder Certificate. Dennis, CPR First Aid Certificate, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamentals Certificate, and a Georgia Best Certificate. Kyle Dickey, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Ellen Easley, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamental Certificate. Caitlin Easley, Nurse's Aid Certificate. Tamia Evans, CPR and First Aid Certificate. Tech and Film Pathway Assessment and Highest Grade in Honors Economics and Government. Keisha Farley, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Kira Farley, CPR and First Aid Certificates. Security Farley, CPR and First Aid Certificate. Takora Farley, Georgia Best Certificate. Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Lauren Franks, highest grade in British Lit and Comm and Art Comprehensive. Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder Certificate. Rakina, oh, sorry. Getting too fast. Here. Rakina Griffin, Georgia Best Certificate. Diana Gutierrez, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamental Certificate. Brianna Harper, highest semester average in Court and Algebra. Cornicia Harris, CPR and First Aid Certificate. Macy Harrison, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Haley Hawkins, Nurse's Aid Certificate. Savannah Hester, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamental Certificate. Ashley Higgs, Most Improved in Spanish 1. Paige Hill, Georgia Best Certificate. Shelby Henson, highest grade in AP Spanish language and 12th grade honors economics. Hannah Houseworth, highest grade in honors 10th grade lit and comm. Jessica Howe, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Kelly Howe, Exceptional Band Performer in Georgia, Certificate of Merit. Jacob Huckabee for accomplishments and dedication in theater arts. Brianna Ewing for accomplishments in leadership in chorus. Key Huggins for Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Eric Humphreys for Criminal Justice and Fundamental Certificate. Precious Hurt, Nurse's Aid Certificate. Asa Jenkins Murray for Musical Theater Blossom Award. honors economics grade and Georgia Best certificate. Peyton Johnson, Vertical and Advanced Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificate. Adia Jones, opening number for Georgia Thespians, British Lit and Comp Highest Average, Georgia Best Certificate, and CPR and First Aid Certificate. Jessica N. Jones for English 1, highest average. Jared Knight, highest average in Spanish 1, highest average in pottery, and a Georgia Certificate of Merit. Kesley Cole, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamental Certificate. Shelby Lawrence, highest average in painting. Clinton Lee, Animal Science Pathway Assessment and Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Welder Certificate. Kristen Lefwich, Agri-Science Pathway Assessment and a Georgia Best Certificate. David Levister, CPR and First Aid Certificate. Daisy Levister for Dance Leadership. Aaron Lewis, Nurse's Aid Certificate. Julia Lewis, Environmental Science Highest Average and Georgia Best Certificate. Olivia Lively, Nurse's Aid Certificate and CPR Certificate. Bradley Loggins, Most Improved in Band and a Nurse's Aid Certificate. Zhang Lohr, Georgia Best Certificate. Mincy Lewell, Nurses Aid Certificate and Georgia Med Certificate. Sydney Major, opening number for Georgia Thespian. Brandon Marshall, Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Welder Wellness Certificate for Georgia Thespian. Alicia Masburn, Nurses Aid Certificate. Deontay McBride, Georgia Best Certificate. Brittany McCraney, Georgia Best Certificate. Alyssa McGrady, Nurses Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Bailey McCready, Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder Certificate and Georgia Best Certificate. Adelaide B, Nurses Aid Certificate. Arnaldo Medina, Vertical Advanced Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificate and the Georgia Best Certificate. Jesus Mendez, Nurses Aid Certificate. Luz Moraz, Criminal Justice and Fundamental Specialist Certificate. Alexis Minchie, Accelerated Coordinate Algebra and Analytic Geometry, Highest Average, Honors 10th Grade Lit Com, Highest Average in Drawing, and Highest Average in Photography. Tristan Mahone, CPR and First Aid Certificate. Angel Monroy, Most Motivated Band Member. Anna Montgomery, Honors American Lit Comp Highest Average, Honors World History Highest Average, and Criminal Justice Specialist Certificate. Cameron Moore, Highest Average in British Lit and Comp. Kiara Moore, Nurse's Aid Certificate. Kayla Morbley, Criminal Justice and Fundamentals Certificate. Emily Morgan, CPR and First Aid Certificate and the Georgia Best Certificate. Jamie Morgan, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamentals Certificate and the Georgia Best Certificate. Shanique Bohorn, Culinary Arts Pathway Assistant and Georgia Best Certificate. Jake Morris, highest average in English 2. Brian Nelson, Criminal Justice Certificate. Camille Nelson, CPR Certificate. Emily Newsom, Georgia Certificate of Merit. Lisa Nieto, Nurse's Aid Certificate and Georgia Best Certificate. LaMay Norwood, Culinary Arts Pathway Assistant. Edith Ortiz, Nurse's Aid Certificate. John Parker, AC Technician Assistant and Universal EPA Certificate. Donnell Penniman, Criminal Justice Specialist and Fundamental Certificate. Jacqueline Penniman, Most Improved in Spanish 2, Nurse's Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Mitzi Perez, Nurse's Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Isabella Petit, Most Improved in Spanish 3, Georgia Best Certificate, Highest Average in American League Comp, CPR and First Aid Certificate, and the Highest Grade in Economics. Abby Piercy, Georgia Best Certificate. Karen Penner, Highest Average in Pre-Calculus and Highest Average in Chorus. Big valedictorian applause, recognized by the state for her acting ability in musical theater and accelerated pre-calculus highest average. Brandon Price, Gas and Basic Shield Metal Arc Welder Certificate. Quanterica Cordman, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Jacqueline Rangel, Nurse's Aid Certificate and the Georgia Best Certificate. Candace Reed, CPR and First Aid Certificate, Georgia Best Certificate. Kiana Reed, Dedicated Dancer. Eddie Rodriguez, Welding Certificate. Jessica Rudolph, the Dance Blossom Award. Samantha Rudolph, Musical Theater Dedication and Georgia Best Certificate. Anna Riles, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Alvaro Sanchez, highest average in biology. Austin Sanders, highest average in, agri-science pathway assessment, vertical and advanced shielded metal arc, too many letters, welding certificate, and Georgia Best certificate. Charles Scott, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment. Scott Sharp, Gas and Basic Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificate. Sachi Shastri, highest average in dual enrollment U.S. history, Georgia Certificate of Merit, highest average in honors chemistry, and highest average in Spanish, too. David Sides, Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Timothy Silva, highest average in accelerated analytic geometry and advanced algebra in honors biology and Spanish 3. Brianna Simmons, criminal justice specialist and fundamental certificate. Kiara Simmons, CPR and first aid certificate. Bailey Sims, Agri Science Pathway Assessment and Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder Certificate. Sabrina Sims, Agri Science Pathway Assessment. Thomas Smalling, highest average in economics. Jasmine Smith, criminal justice CPR and first aid certificate and a Georgia Best certificate. Javon Solomon, Culinary Arts Pathway Assessment, Nurse's Aid certificate and a Georgia Best certificate. Caleb Statham, Gas and Basic Shielded Arc Metal Welder certificate. Delacy Stiles, Nurse's Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Gage Thigpen, Ag Mechanics Pathway Assessment, Agri-Science Pathway Assessment, and Animal Science Pathway Assessment. Blade Thurman, Vertical Advanced Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificate. Esmeralda Tirado, the highest average in AP Spanish language and year-long coordinate algebra. Cole Turner, Georgia Best Certificate. Sterling Underwood, Vertical Advanced Shielded Metal Arc Welder Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. score and the highest average in chemistry. Andrea Vasquez, highest average in human anatomy and physiology. Garius Waller, AC Technician Assistant and Universal EPA Certificate. Kyria Waller, CPR and First Aid Certificate. Emma Warren, highest average in American Government. Kenya Wiggins, Georgia Best Certificate. Sarah Wiggins, Culinary Arts Pathway Assistant. Brandon Williams, Ag Mechanics Pathway Assessment and Gas Space Assessment. Hope Williams, highest average in semester court in algebra and highest average in physical science. Brianna Wimbish, Nurse's Aid Certificate and a Georgia Best Certificate. Abigail Witcher, Nurse's Aid Certificate. Abby Wolf, Most Improved in AP Spanish and a Georgia Best Certificate. Kevin Zong, Georgia Best Certificate. Gary Young, Georgia Best Certificate. Ching Zhao.
We sometimes, as educators, we assume assume that all of you know what we're talking about. So I want to take just a minute to explain. You heard the word certificate many times. You heard the word assessment many times. Our program is very long tonight, but we're so very proud of our students. Those students that you heard that were receiving an assessment, audio video assessment, culinary arts assessment, ag assessment, those students have completed a pathway in those areas, and they took a state test as an end of pathway assessment. And by passing those exams, they have earned industry recognized credentials. So what that means is when they graduate from high school, or even today if they walk out and go apply for a job, they can take that with them and they are more qualified to be employed than me who walks in without those credentials. So we are extremely proud that they have earned a credential to be employed immediately after high school, if not right now. So please give them a round of applause. We're really proud of those students. They have participated in many classes with some of our teachers here, and they have earned this certificate that when they go to be employed, they take that to any employer in the state of Georgia, and that says that they have earned soft skills, they know how to come to work on time, they know how to speak to people, they are going to be a better employee than someone who has not been through that program. So we are very, very excited to be able to offer that program this year, and we plan to continue for many years to come. Also, you heard certificate many times. You heard criminal justice, HVAC, nurse aid, welding, many different welding certificates. Those students have actually completed college programs. The only thing that is preventing them from graduating from college is that they have not graduated from high school. So we're very proud to recognize them tonight for those certificates. And when they are a senior and they walk across our stage and receive a high school diploma, they're going to come right back and they're going to graduate from college on the very same day they graduate from high school. They're going to graduate from Central Georgia Technical College with those certificates. So how exciting is it if you have a child or a cousin or whoever you're here to see, that when they walk across that stage, they're graduating from high school and they're graduating from college on the very same day. Not many people can say that. So let's give these students a huge round of applause. And you also heard the CPR and first aid, and those students are in the healthcare program right now and have not completed that. So next year when you come, you're going to hear those names again, so they will have completed the nurse's aid certificates. So, having said all that, we're going to recognize many of these students again, the seniors. This is all about the seniors from here on out, this portion of our ceremony. Our first students that we're going to recognize are our YES program graduates. These students, we have our YES program, which is our Youth Empowerment for Success grant that we received last year. And students apply to be a part of the program. They have to complete community service hours, certain types of training, and take additional courses. So these students are going to receive this green and white cord, and they will be able to wear that during graduation. So as I call your name, would you please come, and Mr. Lawless and Ms. Burrell will give you your cords. Mr. Burton Ayers. Mr. Kenneth Black. Anicia Clemens. Preston Collis. Tamara Drungle. to Cora Farley. Rakina Griffin. Paige Hill. Corey Johnson. Peyton Johnson. Adia Jones. Kiana Reed. awards to be presented this evening are our Humanities Cords, those are our white cords. These students receiving these cords have taken additional classes above the classes required just to graduate. They have taken additional classes in the areas of social studies, language arts, foreign language, and other humanities courses such as psychology and sociology. So at this time, would the following students please come forward? Haley Bowen. Shelby Henson. Alyssa McReady. Kiana Reed. Shelby Henson. At this time, we would like to recognize and name our honor graduates for the class of 2015. These students have a GPA that is 90 or above. And the way you can become an honor graduate, even if you have a GPA of an 88, students who take the more rigorous courses, like the AP courses, honors level courses, or our dual enrollment Excel level college core credit courses, are given quality points. And so students are rewarded for taking the most rigorous courses by being allowed to graduate with honors. So at this time, we are very proud to name our honor graduates for the class of 2015. Mr. Cameron Moore. Ms. Karen Pinner. Ms. LaCadria Clements. Come stand to the right and left of me as you Mr. Michael Smith. Stephen Bowers. Miss Samantha Rudolph. Mr. Zachary Rothes. Miss Julia Lewis. Mr. Julian Vanga. Ms. Shelby Lawrence. Yeah. Clemens. Miss Dakota Young. Mr. Burton Ayers. Mr. Deontay McBride. Miss Rosie Dennis. Miss Andrea Vasquez. Miss Rakina Griffin. Miss Haley Bowen. Mr. Ching Wong Zhao.
For things that they've done. I thank you so much for supporting us. One more round of applause for our graduates.